Yes, yes, I know. You were saying that Jeanette's brother. Yeah.
Right.
Alright.
You get to have a run when you after Rome, you're okay. In between Rome and Singapore, that's where the trouble really is. Right? All the time, it's been like that the last 2 years.
Jeanette, maybe you should sit down so I can get some of you.
And they're all there in the sense of the seven deadly sins, and they're all in statues as Dante Alighieri saw it himself. And as you go into this chapel,
you'll see that he's sort of generally.
That's his.
Would everyone close up over here, please?
What's that?
No, you stay there.
Don't need me more drinks at the moment.
Hey, don't make a mistake again, do you?
And interdependence for the husband and wife. It calls for a preparedness to give and take, a willingness to forgive and to be forgiven. And furthermore, marriage signifies a relationship recognized by society, a relationship of mutual trust and commitment to each other and to family life in general. This ceremony marks a starting point, a new beginning in a relationship that has already been established. Frank and Jeanette are proclaiming to each other, and to we who witness, and to society at large, their intentions and commitment to the future of their relationship. We've got a well-known reading here from the prophet that Jim's going to read for us.
From the prophet by Cahil Gibran. Then Almitra spoke again and said, "What of marriage matter?" And he answered, saying, "You were born together, and together you shall be forevermore. You shall be together when the white wings of death scatter your days. Ay, you shall be together even in the silent memory of God. And let there be spaces in your togetherness. And let the winds of the heavens dance between you. Love one another, but make not a bond of love. Let it rather be a moving sea between the shores of your souls. Fill each other's cup, but drink not from one cup. Give one another of your bread, but eat not from the same loaf. Sing and dance together and be joyous, but let each one of you be alone. Even as the strings of hate are alone, though they quiver with the same music. Give your hearts, but not into each other's keeping. For only the hand of life can contain your hearts, and stand together, yet not too near together. For the pillars of the temple stand apart, and the oak tree and the cypress grow not in each other's shadow."
John, this part of the ceremony is the declaration that Frank and Jeanette are going to make as a prelude to the vows. So Frank, sharing with Jeanette a relationship of love, understanding, tenderness and laughter. Will you stand by her, respecting her as a person, her individuality, her needs, her changes, and enjoying her love through all your life together. Jeanette, sharing with Frank a relationship of love, understanding, tenderness and laughter. Will you stand by him, respecting him as a person, his individuality, his needs, his changes, enjoying his love through all your life together. This point of time, this is the vows. It's a very special time, and we've had some. Yes, I've got a wee card there. Maybe if we can, Kate, look after the bag so that you can hold hands there together, face one another. You know, perhaps people like.
The reading from the Church of England prayer book is in the form of a prayer. Give them strength to keep the vows they have made, to be loyal and faithful to each other, and to support each other throughout their life, that they may bear each other's burdens and share each other's joys. Help them to be honest and patient with each other, and to welcome friends and strangers into their home. Amen.
Your love is of richest of human values. As rings are without edge or seam, having no beginning and no end, so they symbolize the perfection of love which knows no end.
Let this ring symbolize our forgiveness forever.
Love
together. Let this ring symbolize our love to you.
Let this ring symbolize our love to you.
Symbol of these vows, you have given and received a ring. Let the world now recognize that you are now husband and wife together.
Beautiful.
Right.
Excuse me, I just flipped
it. Oh, sorry.
Didn't prick you with a pen,
did
it? No, nothing. So we extend to you both our congratulations and our good wishes. We extend to you our friendship and love and the support to the promises you've made to one another. May your love deepen and grow through all the trials and triumph life's got left for you. I know you've had lots already, but for whatever happens in the future, you deserve the best now. So this wee part was saying that we go now in peace and in love and in hope.